and gentlemen.
Good evening. Yes.
Welcome to the show. And a very Merry Christmas to you all. Say a Merry Christmas to them all.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
A hell of a long show, this.
Well, Eric, there you are.
Not for me.
My Christmas present from me to you.
Thank you. I'll open it now.
Yeah, no, don't open it now. I tend to get rather emotional in time like this, you know.
I do understand. I'll save it for later.
Thank you. Thank you. Where's mine?
Pardon?
Where's mine?
Just turned 50 and you've forgotten.
Sorry.
Yes.
You forgot.
Never, never.
You got me a Christmas
present for Mr. Wise, please.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. So generous.
There you are.
That is the most beautiful present I've ever seen.
All of the best for you, Ern.
Oh, it's a lovely desk.
Work. Yep.
I'll write some wonderful plays on this desk for you, Eric.
No, it's not the desk.
It's not the desk. It's not the two fellas, is it?
Play your cards right, it could be, yeah.
Not the desk, but what is it?
Okay, boys. Thank you very much. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And don't write with it now, because I do tend to get rather emotional.
Ballpoint pen?
A boil point pen, to put it. Hey, that means it writes on the skin.
Ballpoint?
A ballpoint pen.
And what's that thing hanging down from it?
Well, I snapped the chain at the post office. You've got to be quick and run like hell.
It's a rotten present, that
is. It is, isn't it?
Rotten Christmas present.
I thought of that. Can I open this now?
Yeah, go on, open it.
I wonder what it is.
Well, it's a long player, isn't it?
Eh?
It's a long player.
Oh, really? Mm. Lovely. Marvellous, that.
Yeah.
I don't look really happy. Is it something I've always wanted, like...
Something you've always wanted?
An old Bing Crosby or something like that?
Not Bing Crosby.
No, no. Louis Armstrong?
No, it's not Louis Armstrong.
Ellie Wallace?
No.
Oh.
Des O'Connor. All I said was Des O'Connor.
Leave my hair on, my Oh, God, if you want me to be a goner, get me an LP by Des O'Connor. look at that face!
That's the most unusual record he's ever made.
This is one where he sings the right notes. Just the one?
Yeah. No, side two, track three. He sings the right notes and you hear the slump of the controller as he falls over the controls.
I like that.
Oh, they love it, you see?
You see what I mean?
Oh. Thank you. Oh, yes. That's enough. We've got a dozen more like that.
More like that.
A dozen more.
That is the best record Des has ever made.
You mean there's nothing on it at all?
Did you hear?
Where did you get it from?
Boots.
Boots.
Do you need a prescription? I got it at the poison counter.
At the poison counter.
How do you do?
Have you seen that nose there? Oh, looks like Concord coming out of the hangar for the first time. And those teeth. Like a set of white polars at the end of a long, dark tunnel, you know. It's ridiculous. I feel ill every time. What's the matter?
I like him. Oh, yes. I've always liked him. Smart, intelligent, full of wit, charm, and a lovely singing voice.
Singing voice?
One of the best ever.
You've changed your tune. As far as I'm concerned, I still think he's lovely.
I
think two of your biggest fans.
Two of your biggest fans. Get a chair for Mr. Des, please.
Chair for Mr.
No, cancel that. Make it a three-piece suite. Yes. I got half an acre to bring it on. Half an acre to bring it on.
Oh, it's lovely to see you, Des.
Oh, nice
lovely.
To see
lovely
you.
To see
lovely
you.
To see you. Lovely
to see you. Des, what are you going to sing on our show?
Just well, a moment. Just hold on one second.
What's that?
Look, I don't mind him standing there, but I don't want him singing on the show.
You don't?
I'm not too keen on him standing there, let's face that.
Well, you've got to give him something.
Well, give him a get-well card and send him home.
Well, Des, I don't know what to say, do I?
Just talking about you, Des.
Yeah, we were just talking about you, see, Des.
You haven't stopped talking about me for the past 6 years.
Oh, he's turned nasty, hasn't he?
He's tumbled.
Yes, he's tumbled.
Start crawling.
Hi, Des. I must ingratiate myself.
Lovely to see you. What a great sense of humour you've got.
A sense of humour.
A lovely suit, that. Mm. Marvellous. Of course, with a sense of humour, you need a suit like that.
That's
two for the price of one.
That's not bad. Des, I just bought Eric your latest LP.
Thank you.
Great.
Sing along or desperate. I think it's marvellous.
Sing along.
I tell you what, I'm thrilled. I ran my finger just down one of the grooves, and I was impressed.
Mm. Impressed.
Absolutely fantastic. I shall treasure this for the rest of my life.
Yes.
That may not be too long, Eric. Listen, fellas, may I ask just one simple little question?
Simple little question?
Yes.
No, it isn't.
No.
No, it isn't.
But don't blow too hard.
No, it's something different from that. It's, the insults. Why?
Why?
Week in, week out. Yes. Why? The insults.
Insults?
Who's been insulting her?
You tell us who it is and we'll have him done over, won't
we? Yes, well,
what's happened up with our friends?
No. I'll tell you. You. And you.
Never.
Never.
Never heard anything like that.
Excuse me. It was you, you, and especially you.
Three of us.
Three of us.
I've kept a list of the insults against Desert Connor.
Well, I've forgotten half of those.
Oh, yeah.
There's a whole series there.
I shall read them one at a time.
But we're leaving the country in August, aren't we?
Yeah, we're going in August.
Number one, Eric, I've just heard some good news. Ernie, what good news? Eric, Desert Connor's got a sore throat. Number two, Ernie, Des O'Connor is a self-made man. Eric, I think it's very nice of him to take the blame. Number three, Eric, Des O'Connor is suffering from athlete's voice. Ernie, how do you mean? Eric, when you hear him sing, you want to run.
Make up your mind.
One of these keep moving shows.
Has to be.
Now listen, fellas, I suppose with the new series coming up, you've got one or two insults lined up.
Only one or two, that's all.
Only one or two.
It's my album.
Look at that. So, seeing we know you so well now, we won't use them.
No, we're not going to do them anymore. You're all right.
Anyway, gentlemen.
Mm-hmm. Where?
Now, use.
Oh! Sorry, I come on your line there, didn't I?
Well, all right.
Use the word loosely.
I was just about to say.
I got a feeling I'm interrupting.
No, you're all right.
I'm working you with my foot. Don't worry about it.
I'm beginning to enjoy it. I was just about to say. Are they for keeps or just for lenses?
No, just for lenses.
Hey, I want to know something.
He's been saving them up.
I want to know who's been giving you the injections.
I would like to know one thing. In fact, I don't even have to know it.
Mm.
It's there in my brain, an indelible thought.
She's all new. We never once said indelible thought at rehearsal.
It was all indelible rubbish, wasn't it? Now I tell you one thing. One thought.
I'm home in a minute.
I have come to a solution.
Ah, that's good.
That's good. We've got to it now, haven't we?
Yeah.
A solution.
That one person, and only one person, was responsible for these evil insults.
I'm here.
Who?
Who?
I don't like to name names.
Was it somebody short? Short?
Somebody tall, tall,
with short, fat, hairy legs.
With a tall, fat, hairless head. The man I have in mind, if you'll excuse me.
Certainly.
The man I have in mind is...
Hard.
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 Yes, hard.
Hard. H-A-R-D. Hard. And I'm really enjoying this. What else is he?
Tough.
Tough. T-O-U-G-H. Another word.
Unscrupulous.
U-N-C-R-B.
That's wrong.
Cut it out.
Wise.
Yeah, yes.
Look,
yes. What?
I realize that a lot of this is probably none of your doing. I'm sorry if I've said anything against you or upset you in any way.
No. It's very nice of you. I know you said some naughty things about my plays, but I've forgiven you for that.
Don't worry about that.
Well, that's all right.
With respect, you shouldn't start insulting people. You shouldn't start insulting people until you're famous, is what we are.
Yeah.
Well, with all due respect, if you forgive me saying so, I do believe. I'm just rearranging my underwear at the moment.
I've got news for you. Just rearrange mine.
do feel that I'm equally as famous as either of you two. I get recognized in the street.
So does my dustman. I say, there goes my dustman.
There is one point here, you see. It's easy when you're recognized from the front.
Ah, yes, that's
it's
true.
When you're recognized from the back. That is when you're a big star.
From the back?
From the back.
Look, it's Ernie Wise. Good Lord, Ernie Wise.
Ernie Wise.
Oh, just a moment ago. Take it easy now, girl. Take it easy.
Eric. Huh? Fancy them not recognising me.
I just fancy them, that's all.
Listen, Eric, there's only one thing I'm really concerned about.
Yes?
Now, man to man, I want to know, am I going to sing on a show?
Of course you are.
Now, look me in the eyes. Am I or am I not? And look me in the eyes.
Do I have to look at you? I mean, really close.
Am I going to sing on the show?
You have my word.
Well, that's good enough for me.
Who are you trying now for, guess?
Yehudi Menuhin.
What does he do?
He's a musician, isn't he?
Musician. What's he play?
You know nothing, you. What's he play? Oh, hello, Mr. Menuhin.
This is the BBC here. We've got a very big, great, big, spectacular show going out at Christmas, and we'd like you to take part. Are you interested?
Yes, I am interested. What is the name of the show? The Morecambe Wise Show. And you say you want me to bring my banjo. But I don't play the banjo. Would a violin be any good? It wouldn't. Sorry, can't help you.
Rocky felt a tingle of excitement as his executive jet touched down in Amsterdam. It was his first visit to Italy.
That's knockout, that one.
Yeah. Another mammoth spectacular.
Aren't they all?
Yes. Oh. Have you cut yourself?
No. No. My face is a bit sore. Thanks to that new bathroom cabinet you bought.
Well, what's wrong with it?
It's all those fancy designs on the mirror.
What do you mean?
I just spent the last 20 minutes trying to shave a seagull off my left cheek.
That's very untidy.
I'm not bothered, they're yours. Anne?
Yes?
Just testing. I don't like getting to bed with strangers. Anne? Yes? You think you could do me a favour? Think I could ask for a favour?
There's no harm in asking.
Can I sleep your side of the bed tonight?
Certainly not.
It's a hell of a draught comes in through that window.
No. You'll have sciatica in the morning.
I won't. Well, I've shreddy weak like everybody else.
You always do that, getting to bed with your dressing gown on.
Oh, well, it's a nasty habit. But there are worse.
Why don't you read your newspaper?
How's the mammoth spectacular coming along, then?
Well, I don't know, really. I don't know whether to make it into an historical drama or one of those science fiction ones.
Jules Verne.
Who?
Jules Verne.
Nah. I'm not having any of those French singers in my play. I think I'll make it, science fiction.
I like science fiction.
Do you?
Oh,
yes.
Mm. Flash Gordon, he was one of my favourites. Remember Flash Gordon?
Flash Gordon, yeah.
Used to call my cousin Flash Gordon.
Hmm?
He got 6 months.
I'm going to read your newspaper or annoy me.
I can do both.
It says here, international film star Sophia Loren has turned down an offer from Salou Grade.
Oh, yeah?
She said the grass was too damp.
You are the lowest person I know.
That's good coming from you, isn't it? Me, low?
Yeah.
Well, who was it then? Who was it who won the limbo dancing competition by just walking under the bar beyond?
Oh, I give up. I'm not changing sides. I'm quite comfortable as I am. It's a lovely night out there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Beautiful. Be a lovely day tomorrow. There's a red tint in the sky.
You don't have turkey at Christmas.
Who do?
Eskimos.
Eskimos?
At Christmas, an Eskimo family sits down to a whale.
Oh, interesting.
Let's take a bit of stuffing.
You know that it takes 47 Eskimos to pull the wishbone?
I'm trying to write my mammoth spectacular.
The Chinese.
We left the North Pole, have we? We're in China now.
Chinese, they don't have their Christmas day to the middle of July. Which is ridiculous, really, because all the mince pies will be stone cold. I liked Christmas when I was little. Did you like Christmas when you were a puppy?
I remember you going round to your house on Christmas Day. You just finished your Christmas dinner. I couldn't believe my eyes.
We like kippers.
Kippers for Christmas dinner. At least my father always used to get a bird.
Till your mother caught him with her. In the doorway of the co-op. He got his divvy that night.
I always used to get better Christmas presents than you.
Oh, well, onto that, are we now? All the best toys.
All the best toys.
A bagatelle, a fort, it's all coming up, I know that.
Bagatelle, fort, hired a little dinky.
You still have?
Look, if you're sitting in a draft, why don't you go and close the curtain?
It's a good idea.
I will.
He's not going to sell much ice cream going at that speed, is he?
Lovely night, isn't it?
Lovely full moon out there, Anne.
There's a red tint in the sky.
Yeah.
It's going to be a lovely day tomorrow.
Yes, for some, but not for you.
Why not for me?
That red tint in the sky.
Yeah?
The bank's on fire.
The bank! And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce to you Britain's number one musical comedy star, the very famous, the very well-known Mr. John Hanson. John, you must be my number one fan.
Well, that's very kind of you, Ernie.
It's a pleasure. Yeah. I just love all those songs that you sing.
Oh, yes, you mean from the old musicals?
From the musical, yes. Yeah. Aren't they wonderful?
Lovely.
Songs like, come, come, I love you only. My heart is true. Come, come, my life is lonely. I long for you. Come, come.
Hello, John. How are you?
How are you?
I saw you coming to the car park.
Yes. excellent. As a matter of fact, I was having it topped up with water.
They're all at it.
John, I've always had... I've always had a secret ambition.
Really?
Oh, yeah, but we won't go into that.
To sing in musical comedy.
Oh, listen to this.
Really? Mm. Yeah. I didn't know that.
Yes.
Is he any good?
Is he any good? Yeah. He's only sang with all the leading opera countries in the country, that's
really?
All. He was the one that fixed the wheel when it fell off Doyle's cart. He is known as a singing blacksmith, you know. Opera with a hammer.
Well, it must be good, then. Well, come on, Ernie, let's hear you sing... say something properly now.
Right.
Something from the Stout Children again.
The chocolate song? Yeah.
No, what he said, Stout Children.
I think he
belongs home. I wish he wouldn't be doing that. Soldier. I know what he meant.
How much would you like?
About 2 bars.
Now, I'd like to sing something, one of your favorites.
Oh, yes.
Oh, well, make it the desert song, eh? How about that?
The desert song. Oh, that's the sound that comes to warn you, so.
He's good, isn't he? He's good.
In the night of
the horse
morning,
now, he's on a horse.
The red shadows fall, the rifts will strike with a blow to bring you woe!
Be honest, when did you last see a colour like that?
You know, I never heard singing like that before in my life.
But you see, the point is, he has missed his way through life.
Missed my way?
Yes. He should have been in musical comedy, of course. He's been a fool unto himself.
Obvious.
In what way?
Well, I mean, you take the Sound of Music.
So, he could have been in the Sound of Music?
If he'd have shaved his legs, he would have been in the Julian Adams part. Because there was only 3 for the audition.
Only 3?
Legs. And he had one of them.
Hey, come here.
Was
that you?
That's a relief.
Tell him about when I used to sing at school.
Oh, he used to sing well at school then, eh? Huh.
He heard that?
Yeah.
Yes. Must be living in the desert.
Clean air.
Of course, of course he could sing about at school. Boy soprano.
Really?
Still is, and he's 65 next week.
Ooh, for the wind. For the wings of a dove, I could fly.
It's him. I thought it was you. I thought that was you. Oh, that was great.
I used to sing that at school.
He did at school.
So did I. Yeah.
His teacher used to say to him, Ernest, will you sing Oh for the Wings of a Dove?
Uh-huh.
And his little face would light up, he'd hop onto his shoulder, and he'd be away.
Yeah.
Pretty fellas everywhere.
Well, John, if you'd... if you go and get changed for the big production number...
Yes, yes, of course. What have I got to sing?
Sing?
Yes.
Mm. Number from New Moon. Stout Hearted Men.
Oh, beautiful, that's song. A fine song.
Oh, yes.
Yes,
yes.
The only trouble is, I do need a large chorus to back that, you know.
Yeah. You'll have a large chorus, Sunbeam.
Yeah.
A large chorus, I promise you.
Oh, well, as long as you understand, I just must have a large chorus for that
course,
particular song.
Of course, flaming large chorus. What's the matter, you Frank? Just sing on your own.
Well, gentlemen, it'll be my pleasure.
Of course,
pleasure.
You just go and get
my it. Desert is waiting.
Get off, we don't want that rubbish.
Who are you trying now?
Well, I think that we need a dancer on the show, you see. Somebody to give it a bit of tone.
Yes, that's a good idea.
I'm ringing that fella, what's his name? Rudolph Near-enough.
Nureyev.
Well, that's near enough. Oh, hello. Mr. Near-enough? The BBC here, we've got a great big prestige show going out at Christmas, and we thought you'd be ideal for the show, and we want to know whether you'd like to do it.
A big prestige show? That sounds very interesting. What's the name of the show? The Morecambe Wise Show? Really? Yes? I think I might be able to do it. But tell me, this is rather unusual, isn't it? I mean, what made you think of asking me? You couldn't get Lionel Blair. Rather typical of BBC.
Great pleasure. I'd like to introduce you to the very beautiful, the very talented, the very well-known, the very famous, Miss... Vanessa Redgrave. Miss Redgrave, I think I can say without fear of contradiction, this must be the proudest moment of your life.
Yes,
I do realize that to appear in a play written by the famous Herbie Wise is the great honor.
Ernie Wise, not Herbie, Ernie.
Oh, Ernie Wise.
Ernie Wise.
I beg your pardon.
That's all right, that's all right.
I do realize that to appear in one of your plays is the ambition of every actress.
Of course it is. Yeah. You're a very lucky girl.
Yeah. Good Lord.
What? Are you on a box or is he standing in a hole?
Eric? Miss Redgrave?
Vanilla, how are you?
Vanessa.
Oh. Tastes like vanilla. We had our dad on one of our shows, you know.
He's never forgotten it.
Oh,
they never do.
Very talented man, your dad.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, very talented man. The way he played those spoons up and down his legs, fantastic. Dessert spoons as well.
Yes.
They can be painful if you miss.
Miss Redgrave, I presume you've read my play?
Yes.
It's very good, isn't it?
Yes, well, I was about to say I have read your play, and there's one or two things I'm not happy about. I would like to make one or two changes, if I may.
Leave this to me, you're too upset.
Call me Herbie.
Eh?
Herbie.
She was close. If I could just have a word with you, please, Miss Rednose. You can see how you have upset the little chap.
I wouldn't upset Herbie for the world.
Ernie. I mean, let's face it, in his plays, he's had some of the all-time greats.
Dame Flora Robson.
That's three for a start. I mean, don't forget, you're not the only one with a famous dad, you know. His father's very famous.
Is he somebody important?
Somebody important? His dad. He's only the secretary of the Peterborough Plumbers Association. So if you ever got bunged up, send for his dad.
I'll do that. Well, I'm happy to do your play just as it's written. I'm very sorry, Herbie.
Ernie. Oh, that's all right, Miss Redgrave. The show must go on, in spite of personal feelings.
Yes.
Now, we're not going to do a play right away.
No, no.
Now, I'm going to present my latest spectacular Latin American extravaganza.
That sounds exciting.
It's ring-a-ding-ding. I can promise you that, isn't it?
Oh, we'll all be dancing together.
Lovely.
Be so romantic.
Now, wait a minute. If I can just interject here, there's a slight problem.
Problem?
Well, he's a very tall young man, isn't he? And you're a short young lady.
Yes.
You know. So never the twain you'll meet.
Well, what do you mean exactly? I mean...
Oh, well, you're dancing.
The difference in the height.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
That's enough.
Well, what are we going to do about it?
Leave it to you.
Could I bend down a little?
Bend down?
She's a sport.
Oh, yes.
She's a sport. Are you bending down now?
No.
Would you bend down?
Would you like to bend down anytime?
Yes, certainly.
What do you think?
Well, the... Ooh.
I don't know what happened. Hurt your knees, you see.
Yes, it does.
Anyway, I wouldn't do that, love, because you lose all dignity, and we don't like our guest stars losing their dignity.
No, of course not.
Get off.
Yeah. I'll go and get changed for the dance.
That's right. Yeah.
I'll be right back.
Yes. Right back. She's tall enough to play in goal.
Yes. She's a lovely lady.
Charming.
She's very tall, though.
Eh?
I'm very worried, you know, Eric.
Why?
In this next dance number, this Latin American extravaganza.
Yeah?
You see, because, well, with the difference in height, you see, when I'm dancing with her, I won't be looking straight into her eyes. I'll be looking straight at her,
What?
When I'm dancing with her, you see, I won't be looking straight into her eyes. I'll be looking straight at her,
Why have you gone all red?
When I'm dancing with her, you see, I won't be looking straight into her eyes. I'll be looking straight at her. I'll be looking straight at her.
Get off! You're not that short. It could be the best Christmas present you've ever had.
Ladies and gentlemen, my Latin American extravaganza.
Ooh. Ooh. Hey.
Said they would. Coffee break now for the band, you see.
We stopped?
Yes. Sidle off. Dignity at all times.
Yes.
Who are you trying for now on the show?
I'm gonna go right to the top.
Not Jess Yates.
Higher than that.
There's nobody higher than that.
I want somebody who can do justice to my plays. I'm gonna phone Sir Laurence.
Great idea.
Why not?
Sir Laurence Olivier.
Hello? Is that Lord Oliver? Hello, my lord. This is the BBC here. We're doing a big prestige show at Christmas, and we'd very much like you to appear in it, in the programme. Could you do it?
Oh, that's most extremely nice of you. Well, that's very flattering. I'd love to appear. Christmas Day, yes. But, just tell me, what's the name of the programme? Very, very sorry. Long number. Chinese laundry here. Sorry, sorry.
Well, Edrich.
Must be about 95.
Must be.
Jeez. Inspiring. Pouring out me.
Would you, excuse me just a moment?
Sure, go ahead.
It won't be long.
No.
All right.
Two, three, four.
fella. I'm sorry, that's very, very, very pretty, but when do I get to sing my song?
Yes. Now.
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 Are you sure?
Yes.
You heard right then. Yes, yes. Keep going, you fool.
We've built the most magnificent set for you, just for you.
You put...
Yeah, the steps. Yes. There's thousands of steps, and they all go down like that. Not like that. Like that. Yeah. And the three of us at the top of the steps, and we go, la-la, and we walk down, and you sing your song right now.
My steps.
Your steps.
Especially made for you.
Let's do it. Come on.
Come on.
Good idea.
Eric.
Yes.
My steps.
Sorry.
This is it, Ern?
Yeah. Everything for the mother-to-be.
The clubhouse. Easy terms and 9 months to pay.
Yeah. I don't feel right in this sort of place.
It's not catching. I'll tell you one thing. If Match of the Day was on every night, this place would have to close down.
It's embarrassing enough without you doing jokes.
Well, it's be embarrassed.
Hey!
What?
Why are those frocks so big?
I'll tell you about it one day.
Oh.
Just get what you want and then we'll go.
No, I'm embarrassed.
There's no need to be embarrassed, is there?
I know.
I'm with you.
Don't smoke in here.
Huh?
Don't smoke in here.
Oh, all right. Sorry.
Yes.
If it wasn't for that one little word, this place would have to close down.
Look, if you're going to do jokes, I'm leaving.
Jokes? No. See, he's highly nervous.
Oh, yes. We often find that the fathers-to-be are more nervous than the mothers-to-be.
I'm not the father-to-be.
It's his sister.
Ah.
She's the father-to-be.
It's my sister, Annie.
Well, have you anything in mind?
Well, I've never done this sort of thing before.
Sister Annie said that.
And when is the happy event?
In 2 weeks' time. And stop embarrassing me.
I'll go with her.
Yes,
yes, I think you might be a little more considerate. Mm.
Just watch it. If it wasn't for me, you could be redundant.
Well, I suppose this is the right moment to get something for the little one.
The very thing that I had in mind.
But there's so much to choose from.
If you've got the saucer for this, I'll take it. Doggone!
Ah, well, look, you bastard!
I'm only trying to take the sting out of it for you. Oh. Get what you want and then go. Uncle.
Uncle? Gosh, that's true.
Yep.
I'll be an uncle.
Of course you will.
Do you think the baby will look like me?
I don't see why not. You sell masks. Do you sell masks?
Well, I'm getting out of this place. I'll take this.
Oh, excuse me, sir. We find that usually the first thing anybody buys the little one is a rattle. Your sister's husband will already have bought one.
My sister's what?
Your sister's husband.
Husband?
Yes.
My sister hasn't got a husband. My sister's not married. As a matter of fact, my sister had nothing to do with men. She doesn't like men. She wouldn't let a man touch her any time, I'm telling you. I don't like that sort of thing myself, either. All that nasty business that goes on. It's not nice. All that fumbling and crumbling, I know about that.
Excuse me, just a moment, please.
What's the matter?
Could I have a word with you?
Yeah.
Well, what you don't seem to understand.
Yeah. Well, I know
how
that.
How much is that?
Yeah, I know.
Right?
Yeah.
Now, that's nothing to do with the new bread.
No. What?
Rainy night.
Rainy night.
You know, the log fire, the warm champagne, the quick...
Yeah. What's that?
I've hurt my neck.
Oh. And then and with him, and they...
Of course.
My sister Annie did that.
What? There's got to be a father somewhere.
All right, then. Let the father buy the rattle for the baby.
I'm sorry about that. She's terribly upset. How much is it?
50 pence.
I'll take it.
Mr. Wise, I wonder if I could ask you just a few questions.
Of course, as long as you treat me with the politeness due for a man in my position.
I shall certainly do that, Mr. Wise.
Now, what would you like to ask me, Mr. Day?
Nothing, really, except, why don't you resign?
That's the most ridiculous question I've ever heard. You are next to an idiot.
How do you do?
I will. Now, watch it.
Mr. Wise, you are deliberately trying to be evasive.
If you were a little less bombastic, we might get somewhere.
With all due respect, Mr. Wise, and that isn't very much, I must ask you to watch your language.
Not only are you bombastic, you're a little short on good manners also.
Mr. Wise, I'm not in the habit of losing my temper, but I must ask you to be very, very careful.
Now listen, you just listen to me. You may be bigger than me, but you don't frighten me for 1 minute. You know, I can go a bit. So just you watch it, that's all. I didn't come here to be insulted.
Where do you normally go? Why?
I'm going to punch you. Stand up. How dare you treat me like
that? Well, sadly, we've come to the end of Robin Day's friendly discussion. Next week, Robin Day's friendly discussion will be with President Amin. And the subject will be how to make friends and influence people. Until next week. Good night.
I'm Vanessa Fielding. I worked with Morecambe and Wise, and look what happened to me. Mind the door!
I'm Eric Porter. I was on the Morecambe and Wise show. Look what happened to me.
And love and romance. Let's face the music and dance. There may be teardrops to shed. So while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance.
I won't tell.
She won't.
dance.
Don't ask her.
I won't dance.
She won't dance.
Don't ask her.
I won't dance.
She won't dance.
Madam, with you.
My heart won't let my feet do things they should do.
You know what?
Know what?
I'm lovely.
And so what?
So what?
I'm lovely.
You know what?
What you do to me? I'm like an ocean wave that's bumped on the shore. Must you dance every day with the same fortunate man? You have danced with him since the music began. Won't you change partners and dance with me? Quite so close, with your lips touching his face. Won't you change partners and dance with me? You may never want to change partners again.
Tell you about the new play, what I've just wrote.
Oh, yes.
It's entitled Cyrano de Bergerac.
Oh, knock out that.
Yeah, and in this, you have got the lead. You play the star, Cyrano de Bergerac.
Great, thanks a lot.
Now, this is what I want you to do. Yes. You see? Well, you've got to learn a lot of poetry, you see, all that about I am Cyrano de Bergerac, I've got this big nose. And then you've got to learn to be a good soldier.
Ladies and gentlemen!
Ladies and gentlemen, I can't believe
I'm in three doors! Isn't this wonderful?
Yes, it's your friend of mine, Mr. Francis Matthews.
Who is it?
Francis Matthews.
All good.
Are you looking forward to the show, Francis?
Oh, I'm looking forward to it immensely.
Oh, good, 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 good.
Well, I'm looking forward to it.
Good, good.
Well, I'm looking.
Yes.
I need the money.
You need the money. Well, in this, you play the part of Count de Basie.
Oh, what? Two.
Well, what? Two. Eric, I think he'll be very good in the part of
One of the finest men you've ever had, I'll tell
yes,
you that.
Yes, I think he'll be excellent in the part. Eric.
Yes.
Are you partaking of intoxicating liquor?
No, rheumatism.
Oh, rheumatism.
Rheumatism. I can't bend my elbow like
oh,
that.
What a shame.
I can't do that.
No, you can't.
Not with that arm.
No.
I can't with that arm either.
No.
That's why I have this.
Francis, lovely to see you. Have you read my play?
No, my wife read it to me in bed last night.
Oh. Now, it's funny you should say that, because my wife and I, we've reached that stage as well.
Sad, really. Yeah. You can't have everything in life.
No.
And I never did.
What is your wife think? Francis, what did your wife think?
Oh, that was an extra one.
Extra one, yeah. What does your wife think of my play?
Oh, she said if I took part in it, I'd be demeaning myself.
Oh, well, it's not a nice
thing. What a lovely expression. Took part in it.
Yes.
He's doing it again. He's doing it again.
Francis, what are you doing?
Yes.
Are you a hard drinker?
Not at all. I find it very easy.
I wish I had thought of that.
Well, if I could tell you about my play. It's an historical play. Just a minute.
Yeah. Why are we doing it on a... Why are we doing it on a revolving stage?
A revolving stage?
Oh, yes. Why are we doing it on a revolving stage?
What are you trying to...
Answer her!
Why is your speech all slurred?
Well, the floor's slippery.
This isn't a revolving stage.
Like that. Well, it feels
the
like
floor's
it.
Slippery. Did you hear that?
Good evening.
Come on. Can we get on tonight?
Certainly, yes. I'm ready when you are.
Okay.
That's a good idea.
Yes, yeah. Thank you.
Here, help
thank
yourself.
Thank you very much.
Will save you of that, there's no doubt. I'm off to the castle to get Robin out. For Robin's the bravest man what I have seen. He's been having lessons from old Richard Green. With a daffy down dilly and a nonny as well, I'll tell you of Robin who lives in the dell. Pursued by the sheriff, he cares not a fig, as he polishes his sword on Little Ern's wig.
Leaning on a lamp.
All right.
You know that one?
I'm leaning on a lamp.
Hey ho, lackaday! 6 months gone and no sign of Robin yet.
Hey!
Have you letters about that?
I hope all goes well for him in Sherwood Forest. If only I had news of him.
Hello there!
It's Little Ern!
Surely the most fair and beautiful sight in the whole of Sherwood. And you're looking well too, Marion.
Tell me you bring me news of Robin.
I most certainly do, Marion.
Then I implore you, impart it to me in haste. Know you not that my uncle, the Sheriff of Nottingham, is at hand? I fear for your life.
Tut-tut, tut-tut. As outlaws care not for the Sheriff of Nottingham. You see, all summer we have been in Sherwood Forest merry many, shooting the king's deer and playing conkers. I've got a 49er. Impressed?
Oh, yes. Tell me, where is Robin?
Why, here he comes now.
Even all? I'm sorry I'm late, but it was my own stupid fault. The man told me the castle was in Notting Hill. Good Lord, Marion. Are you still knitting that tambourine? Well, do your dress up, otherwise you'll get earache, you know that. And is the tea made, Marion? Would you like some snuff? I'm sitting at my piano. I'll do more.
You are in great danger, Robin.
Why, can't you wait? You'll have to learn to wait. It's me, folks, Robin Hood, as tough as old boots I am. And you know why? Because the stars are my blanket, the dewy green grass is my bed, and the cold night frost is my pillow.
I haven't seen you for weeks.
I've had pneumonia.
You must leave this castle at once. Your life is in dire peril.
Ah, well, before there's one dire, we'll have a little ode. You'll find me, me man, camping down on the green, living off nothing but rabbits. It's a terrible diet. You better not try it, because it gives you peculiar habits.
Comes King Richard now!
The meat is under the stairs. I'm not working with this woman.
Your Majesty!
Ah.
Your Highness!
Ah. King Dick! Van spotted you first. He said, look out, here comes Miss United Kingdom. Leave me all.
We'll have none of that. It's early for that.
I'm very sorry I'm late, but it is my own stupid fault.
Oh, is it?
Oh, really? I was enjoying a roundelay at the Blue Boar Inn when I slipped and twisted a madrigal.
He's doing all my
And not only that, he's masking me as well. But what could be worse than a little verse?
Hello, this is it.
Yeah.
The king stood on the burning deck. The men all shouted, monarchs!
Just a moment!
Well, you've got to draw the line somewhere, and that was it. Yes, and you can see the join with that crown. Well, I'm very sorry, I am doing my best.
It's not good enough.
No. It's time you retire.
Excuse
is she
me.
Doing it now?
It pleases me to see your Majesty, but should the Sheriff of Nottingham find you, I fear he would kill you. If aught should befall you, I would take me to a convent.
Don't forget to leave the window open like you promised. A fine woman, Robin. I haven't looked.
Your Majesty, may I ask you... May I ask you a question? But, how did you know that we were here?
Well, surely little Ern is one of Robin's men.
One of who's...
You know the ways
if
of the
you don't
forest.
Know me now, you never will. It's not Rosin, it's
no.
Robin. Robin is what you dry your feet on, isn't it?
Robin's men,
eh? Oh, but to be full of mallards in a minute.
The ways of the forest. You know the ways of the forest.
Oh,
the ways of the forest. The bees tell the trees tell the hairs tell the trout.
And you shake it all about, yeah. And you do a hokey pokey and turn around. And that's what it's all about. Be honest.
Robin.
Yes.
Now, I wutzed the word with thee.
Wutzed?
Wutzed?
Gutzed.
Sit, sap.
What's on your mind, sunshine?
It's been a long time, Robin.
I can see that.
Do you know what I've missed most?
There's got to be trouble here, huh?
Yes.
Do something quickly.
I'll change the subject.
Yes.
Your Majesty.
Something else while you're at it.
Your Majesty, how did you get into the castle? Ah, I entered by the goose gate.
Oh, you took a chance.
Ah, but I am sorely grieved.
I'm not surprised. What time did you get in there? 10:30? Such of the forelock, you've had it down there, I can tell you.
Your Majesty, please speak. It is this.
Ah, what's this?
What is it?
It's a note or something.
No, no, it's a football result. Have we gone on? Down again. That was a message.
A message, you say?
Informing me...
Yes?
...that the Sheriff of Nottingham...
Nottingham?
...intends to put me to the sword.
Oh.
And place my brother, Prince John... upon the throne of England. How do you see it, Robin?
I beg your pardon, sir?
How do you see it?
Very rarely these days. That is true, Mr. King. How's your brother, Dave?
Very well.
Still working?
Lads, we have much to do this night.
That is true.
But first...
What?
Let us feast.
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
Ah, a goodly repast.
It is a goodly repast, yes.
Ah, sit. The Sheriff does himself well.
He does that.
Chitterlings.
Eh? Just watch it, that's all.
That's the chitterlings, that's all.
Oh, the soup sausages.
Yes, that's it. Do you know?
What?
They had fresh riots in York this morning.
Really? How much?
£2 a pound.
Quite cheap. Candle.
Man of Sherwood. I give you a toast.
Hey!
Gentlemen. To the Sheriff of Nottingham and all like him.
Death to the Sheriff of Nottingham and all like him.
The King, Robin Hood, and Little Ern. A fine catch.
You're tracked.
It's a lovely hat, that.
My men have surrounded the castle and have orders to kill on sight.
You little scare us, young sir. Because we are on an action replay, aren't we?
Yes.
Well, all right, we're safe.
And what have you got to say, little Ern?
What have I got to say? I've had enough of you. I'm going to banish you to Crossroads.
But you can't escape this time. What do you say to that, King Richard?
The king stood on the burning deck, his pocket full of crackers.
Now that's enough.
We can't have this in front of her.
No.
I must tell Prince John.
Yes, if he hasn't heard it, he ought to be ashamed of himself.
And you can't escape this time.
Ah, shut up. Ah, lads, that it should end like this.
Oh, is it? A bit weak, but nevertheless.
No, no, it's not the end.
Isn't it?
No, of course you've forgotten about one thing.
What?
The Merry Men!
The Merry Men! Where are the Merry Men now?
Hell, we're gone. Some of them.
Yes, you summon the Merry Men.
You leave everything to me.
They are. Oh, they are.
They are.
Yeah, well,
you
are.
I'm a higher halt. Has it gone?
You didn't put a note on the end of it.
Well, I can't write, can I?
Use your blower.
I will, yes.
Sorry about that.
There's dust everywhere. Was that you?
Soon this place will be swarming with merry men.
In goodly numbers, I
trust. 100!
Excuse me.
Here we are now!
You said 100!
Well, he is tomorrow.
Yeah. Hello, sunshine! Tell him what I want you to do. Go and warn the men. You understand? Are you deaf? Warn the men! Go warn the men! And mind the malt! He's just got this back from mother care this morning, this outfit.
Yeah. He's a credit to us merry men.
Mind the malt!
A fine man.
Yes.
But do you think he'll get through?
Yes? We're through.
Sheriff and his men again.
No, no,
that was your last attempt at escape. Prepare to perish. Little Ern goes first.
Right, you swine, you.
We shall fight you to the death, sir. No man usurps the throne of England. Not while I am Richard of England. No man, I tell you. And when your head rolls. When your head rolls, rolls.
True.
Prepare to die.
Is that the rubber one?
Yes.
Under the arm.
No, this one, you fool.
Let go.
What's the perfect of the hand, Lindley?
Put them to flight.
Robin.
Why? Robin has been wounded. He's hurt. Please, Robin, try not to speak.
You must be joking.
I'm going, Ern.
No.
Oh, yes, I am, I know. I'm going, aren't I?
Yes, he's going, definitely.
You can always tell, can't you?
Very determined.
Do me a favour.
What?
Before I go, little Ern.
Yes, Robin?
Fetch me my trusty bow and arrow.
Where is it?
In the dressing room.
Right.
Rest easy, Robin.
Oh, yes, I will. Mind you, I must be honest, I've never had a dying part in one of Ern's plays before.
Really?
No, the nearest I came to it was about 2 months ago. Mrs. Mills fell on top of me. Yes, it was for both of us.
Robin?
We were on top of a bus at the time.
I found it in Glenda's dressing room.
Shh, don't tell the others.
Time for a Castello.
Robin.
Yes?
Why do you want your bow and arrow?
Yes.
Wherever this arrow lands, there you will lay me. You're not dealing with a mug, I'll tell you that.
Thinking, that's what I told the man, said, don't wear a frown, try.
try positive thinking. Laugh at your troubles instead. You've got to look on the bright side. All hope so much depends. How with your confidence sinking, positive thinking helps you on the way, my friend. When things look black, try positive thinking. Treat every season as spring, no glancing back. Try positive thinking. Trust what tomorrow may bring. This crazy world, what we live in, will keep on spinning round. Better be good, strong, positive thinking. Good, strong, positive thinking. Good, strong, positive drinking. We'll get together.